All right, now that we've talked about the principles of internal controls, it is super important for you to understand that there are limitations with internal controls. The limitations here are internal controls are created and applied by people. There's no question. There's no AI that does this. People are the ones that create that. The human element can create several potential limitations, and it's important for you to be able to identify the two types of limitations. You have what's called human error, and human error is simply based, it's a mistake. It was an accident. You transpose two numbers. Maybe you're tired and you made a misjudgment or something like that, but it's just a simple mistake. Does that mean that you don't get, you know, there's no repercussions? Of course there is, but it's probably not as severe as the next one, which is human fraud. Human fraud has to do with the intent to deceive or go get past the internal controls. So when you're looking at these limitations and something around the internal controls, you need to ask yourself the question, was it just simple mistake or was it actually the intent was there? Obviously, the repercussions for fraud are going to be a little bit heavier. Now, when you go through this, it is important when you're dealing with internal controls that you want to keep in mind the cost-benefit constraint, and that is it can also be a limitation, as it states that the costs of the internal controls. I'm only as good as what I put into it. So I'll give you an example. If you're dealing with putting a camera up, and let's say me in class, and I have 40 students in my class, and they're all taking a test. Could I put 40 cameras above each one above each student as they take their test to keep with my internal controls? And would it work? Well, of course it would. I mean, I would have one camera per student. I would be able to go review the film, see if they're cheating, blah, blah, blah. But is it cost effective? Or is it what I call an overkill? Well, yes, I don't need 40 cameras. Really, if I was going to do this, I would need one, maybe two in the behind, you know, one in front, one in the back, and I can keep up with that. That's the cost benefit. I'm not going to get my cost back if I put 40 cameras up, that I'm going to get the same thing out of a one camera or two cameras. So that's another thing that you need to look at is the cost benefit there, or is there something else? As technology becomes more and more cost available, then naturally more and more things will happen. But right now, you know, there is the overkill. So keep that in mind as you're putting in place these internal controls. Appreciate it.